shocked. And I'm like, so his name was Jimmy. I said, Jimmy, I said, are you sure? I'm going to Wharton Business School. Yeah, what's going on? We need some money. We can make some money. These guys, you give them a couple $1,000 each. And they'll do whatever you say. So thinking. Not about fixing games. Not about any of that. About editing some information. And he tells me he's come up with this idea. A couple hours before game time. Driving the car, and he'll hit him from behind. He'll go to the hospital, no one will know. We'll bet the game, and by the time they find out, it'll be too late. We already bet it. We're not going to be playing. The team's going to lose. So that was his idea. I thought about it for a couple seconds longer. I said, Jimmy, I don't want no parts of it. I don't want nothing to do with fixing games. But that's how easy it is to fix a game. But that was the first time I was. Pride in what I do. I deal with some of the sharpest people in the country and the world. What we do is a lot of work, it's a lot of sweat. We take pride in our profession. We're professional gamblers, and we win based on information, based on our handicap, our power rankings, based on our opinions. And to cross that line, some guys like to cheat, but the sharpest gamblers in the world, they do not cheat. They don't have to cheat. The guys who ain't as sharp, the guys that want that quick money, the guys that think small, think short term. We think about the big picture, long term. So we know, okay, we're gonna pay these guys off. God forbid someone picks up. Those kids, they're gonna tell them everything. They're gonna get in trouble. It's not worth losing our freedom, losing our bankroll, losing our credibility in the sports betting market to be known as a fixer. I'm a gambler, I'm not a fixer. That's why we don't. Some people do it, some people don't. The smart ones don't do it. The ones that ain't that sharp might want to get into it. I mean, you get approached all the time only because they don't have the outs. They don't have where to bet the games. Now, I've been gambling for over 25 years. I mean, I can move $1 million in a game. I can move $2 million in a game. I have so many apps where I can bet with so many different people. Where if someone wants to fix a game and he knows a couple people, it's really not worth it. So that's why guys like me, there's other guys like me out there, will get approached because they have the apps to move the funds. That's why.